So let us come back to the discussion of accounts payable. Accounts payable is actually the major source of short-term financing, unsecured short-term financing. Not secured is different. Okay, this is the major source. So why accounts payable is a source? Because accounts payable mean you will actually keep other people's money within your business, okay, until you pay it. So this is a major source of unsecured short-term financing. And I have already mentioned that accounts payable is the result from the transaction of merchandise purchases. When you purchase from the supplier, you have accounts payable. That means you have your supplier's money with you. Okay, so you can use that money for your business for a short period of time. And I have already mentioned that if you pay to the supplier after 30 days, then you have a financing of 30 for 30 days. If you pay it for after 40 days, then you have financing for 40 days. If you pay it after 60 days, then you have a financing period of 60 days. So which one is better? Paying after 30 day or 40 day or 60 day? Which one is better? So the more time you utilize the other people's money, the more you do your business. Okay? So this is why we are saying that actually how many days you can finance, okay, that depends on the average payment period. How many days you take to pay to your supplier. That is called average payment period. It has two parts. Okay, it has two parts. One is the time from the purchase, okay, time from the purchase of raw material until the firm mail the payment. Okay, so let's say we purchase on January 1 and we send the check on January 15. So 15 days is one part of the average payment period. Okay, and do you think that the supplier can get the money right on January 15? No, actually they will take some more days. Let's say 2 days, January 17, okay, to collect the check. Okay, 2 days. So why will they need the 2 day time? Because actually what will happen, they will collect the check from from whatever source you have sent, probably from the post office box or whatever. They will enter the information about the check, they will process the check, they will submit the check to the bank, to their bank, and their bank will collect it from your bank. So the whole process may take 2 days or 3 days or 4 days, whatever. So let's say it takes 2 days. So you can see we have total 17 days of delay, in payment, and that is called average payment period. Now, in these 70 days, we have two types of delay. One is from the time of the purchase to sending the money to the supplier, and the second portion is sending the check to the supplier. Second portion is from the day of the sending the check to the supplier until the check has been cleared by the supplier. Okay, so these are the two parts of the average payment period. Is that clear?